Reports, Introduction, by Zachary Koppelman. When you write a report, you are explaining what you did, why you did it, how it worked, what you found, and why it matters to a wider audience than just yourself or your team. To some degree, reports are the justification for a project. The purpose of this vidcast is to introduce layering reports. Walking the reader through how the project developed focuses the reader on the results, the reasoning, and the logic behind design decisions. It shows the reader how you got from an idea to a prototype to a product, all in a way that the reader can understand and replicate. Reports follow a fairly common structure and flow, and can be divided into layers, with each layer fulfilling a specific purpose. By examining and understanding the complementary function of each layer, it becomes easier to compose individual layers and combine them into a final document. Generally speaking, reports will have five layers. Each layer has a specific audience, and thus a specific purpose and function, which dictates what information each layer needs to include and how that information needs to be presented. For example, an executive will only read the title page and executive summary. A manager will read the majority of the report, but most likely not the appendices or the references. Other engineers, consultants, and contractors will read the entire report and carefully examine and verify the appendices and the references. Here's a brief overview of each layer. Title page. Typically one page. The title page is first and has a concise yet descriptive title, normally 5 to 12 words long. A concise and descriptive title allows the reader to understand the subject of the report right from the beginning. And a descriptive title helps arrange the report with similar projects. For example, general titles like Report 1 say nothing about the topic of the project, but makes the report hard to file, store, making retrieving past projects very difficult. In crafting a title, consider identifying both the what and the how. Specifying the how will often distinguish the project from many other projects with the same what. For example, the title, Travel Tricycle for Easy Assembly from PVC Components, is specific without too much length. In addition to a descriptive title, the title page also includes a list of the project contributors, possibly with space for signatures, company affiliations, and the date of the submission. This information is used in archiving the report. Executive summary, typically one page. An executive summary is intended for your boss's boss or higher. It is called an executive summary because it is designed for executives to read and use. It functions as a short but comprehensive overview of the project, and it has four main components. Purpose, first sentence. Procedure, typically one to two sentences. Results, majority of the page. And conclusions, one sentence. Each component needs to be precise and direct. The executive summary is a mini report, and it must be able to stand alone. A reader should be able to fully understand the motivation of the project, major aspects of the project, and the results of the project from only reading the executive summary. Executives do not have a great deal of time, and they need to make informed decisions about many projects and the time it would take them to read the entire report for a single project. They need the key facts, particularly the results and conclusions, clearly stated and logically arranged so they can read the executive summary and make an informed decision. A poorly written executive summary can cost companies millions of dollars and dozens of jobs. Introduction. Typically one page. Just as the title reflects, this section introduces the project and is typically a subpart of the body of the report. It has two main parts, the purpose and the preview. The purpose describes the motivation of why this project was undertaken, data may be cited to demonstrate and validate the need of the project. The preview is a brief summary of what is contained in the report. It functions like a thumbnail image on a shopping website. It gives enough information for your boss to generally understand the design process you followed without providing any specific results or conclusions. The introduction does not provide the reader with a mini report like the executive summary does. The introduction is an overview of the report, a map for the reader to follow. Body. Length can vary significantly depending on the project. Talk to your instructor or supervisor for more specific guidelines. The body of the report explains in greater detail exactly what the project was about, what discussions occurred, what decisions were made, what was done, how the project worked, what resulted, and what those results mean. The body is a detailed map of the project. It contains enough information for someone else to replicate the project and understand why the project was carried out as it was. There are always options for solving problems. The body explains which options were used and how they worked. In essence, it is a greatly expanded version of the executive summary. Appendices. Length can vary significantly depending on the project. At times, appendices can be extensive. Appendices contain the background data and details that support your work. They function as an extension of the body of the report. They contain information, calculation, schematics, and figures of the project that weren't deemed important enough to be included in the body of the report. This does not mean that all the calculations, schematics, and figures need to go in the appendices. It means that secondary or supporting details need to be mentioned in the body, and the reader should be referred to the information in the appendices. The information in the appendices should be well documented and clearly presented. It should not just be thrown together in a haphazard manner. The appendices are there for if you get hit by a bus on your way into work. Another engineer should be able to go through your detailed appendices, see exactly what was being done, the results of those actions, and reconstruct your work. References. Typically one page. Your references page is your connection to the rest of the engineering community. You can cite other researchers or engineers in order to show your readers where they can find the same information. Citations direct readers to find more discussions about similar projects that you used in your decision-making and option implementation. With the references, you can literally connect readers to anyone in the world conducting similar work. The next vidcast in this series will focus on the title page and the executive summary. If you have any questions, please talk to your TA. This has been Layering Reports, Introduction by Zachary Koppelman, in cooperation with the Purdue Online Writing Lab and prepared for the Mechanical Engineering Writing Enhancement Program.